Should I repair or replace my computer? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This turns out to be a question I recently found myself asking myself. I have a computer that was having some issues, and it was getting to the point where this question, should I just repair or replace the thing, came up. In doing so, it caused me to think about a number of different issues. To be clear, there is no blanket answer. It really does depend on the situation, the specifics of the situation you're facing. However, I do have some things that I looked at, some things that are worth considering as you try and make what for many people is actually a fairly difficult decision. One of the first things that enters into the equation, of course, is your budget. Now, I say that not for the obvious case where a new computer costs X amount of dollars and that X is too large. Unfortunately, it's not that simple. Repairing a computer can also cost you. Depending on exactly how you go about repairing your machine, it can cost you in parts, it can cost you in a service if you hire somebody to do the work for you. So it's not necessarily a simple answer, but it is probably the thing people think of first. So I want you to be very careful. When you take a look at replacing your computer, that's great. You know what that's going to cost you, but make sure to balance that against the cost of repair. You may find that repairing could be as expensive in some cases, if not close to as expensive as just replacing the machine. On the other hand, sometimes a repair can be very, very inexpensive, particularly if you can fix it yourself. Now, this is something that not everybody is up for. I totally get that. Obviously, if something breaks on one of my computers, one of the first things I'm going to do is see if I can fix it myself. And in fact, in the scenario that I had, that's exactly what I did. I spent a fair amount of time trying to resolve the issue at hand on my own. The problem here is that this has what I'll call a hidden cost. That hidden cost is your time. It's going to take some amount of time for you to do this work. And I'll just be honest and say the result that you or I as non-professional computer repair folks might not be up to the same level of quality or give you the same kind of result that somebody who does this for a living might actually get you. On the other hand, repairing things yourself is almost always less expensive as long as you end up with the desired result. Now, one of the things I also factor into the equation on some of these decisions is just how old the computer is. If it's a relatively new computer, then it may, of course, be worth spending a little bit more time and a little bit more money to bring it up to snuff, to fix whatever the problem is you're having with it. On the other hand, if it's an older computer, well, then you may not want to be quite as aggressive about repairing it. It might very well be time to consider replacing it with something newer. Now, rather than just discarding that computer, when you're dealing with an older machine, again, depending on the failure mode, you might be able to be less aggressive about repairing it. That's why I use this term, and use it in some kind of diminished capacity. As we'll see in a moment, that's exactly what I've done with one of the machines that I'm having a problem with. I have to mention the warranty. This is one of those things that a lot of people overlook, mostly because it can be so very inconvenient. But the bottom line is that if your machine is within warranty and it fails, exercise the warranty. I realize it's going to be inconvenient. More often than not, it means sending the computer back for repair, being without it for a while. That can be an issue. I get that. But the warranty is there for a couple of reasons. One is you paid for it. You deserve to get this thing fixed if it's under warranty. And also, it's important for the manufacturer to know that their machines are failing. You, of course, see just a single failure, but if everybody is experiencing or a large number of people are experiencing the same failure, the only way a manufacturer is really going to not only hear about this, but hear about it in a way that they have to pay attention to it, is if people return the machine for warranty repair. So please, please, if it's under warranty, please do consider doing that. Now that does like I said, factor into another consideration, and that's this concept of what I call convenience and speed. It's not always possible for us to do without our machine for the length of time that a warranty repair, or for that matter, any repair might take. Need is real. If you're a small business and your primary computer, the computer perhaps maybe that you use for your point of sale system, fails, you need to get that fixed immediately. That, of course, then drives a lot of the other decisions. You may need to spend more. You may need to find someone local. You may need to find someone who can fix it quickly. You may need to not waste any of your time on it and focus on getting the machine repaired as quickly as possible. So that's something that is also very difficult to factor in, but it is also very important to understand based on exactly how this particular failing machine is being used and just how important its mere presence is for whatever it is you're doing. Now, one of the things I have to bring up whenever we talk about replacing a computer is the concept of change. Many of the computers that eventually fail have been around for a while, and they're often running older versions of the operating system. I'll just use Windows 7 as an example. No longer supported, but of course it works. I mean, if it's working for you, that's great. There are ways to keep it running safely and securely. But if you end up needing to replace that machine, you're not going to get Windows 7. You're going to get Windows 10 or perhaps even Windows 11 at this point. Point there is that you're going to be faced with some amount of change. Now, obviously, I'm an advocate for accepting change, embracing change even. Your experience with technology will be significantly better if you're willing to at least embrace and accept change. However, I realize also that that's not for everybody. So, the repair or replace decision is also colored by this willingness to accept change. Knowing that if you get a new machine, you're going to get a new operating system might cause you to spend a little bit more effort, a little bit more time, and expend a little bit more resources on getting the existing machine repaired so that you don't have to go through the upgrade or the operating system change or whatever other change might be involved in getting a new machine. If you end up getting a new machine, one of the things I strongly recommend you do is consider, given the state of the broken machine, how broken is it? Can you put it in another role? Can you use it for something else? Is it still salvageable even if you don't repair it or if you don't repair it completely? For example, we'll take a look at my example here in just a second because that gives actually a very, very clear example of having a machine that works, but it's broken. And that means I can't do everything I want with it. The story is a very long one. I'm going to try and keep it short. A couple of years ago, I purchased a brand new laptop from Dell. It was at that time intended to be my desktop machine for various reasons. It's no longer my desktop machine, but it's still a very nice, powerful laptop. I ran into a scenario where removing the power, in other words, unplugging it from line power, would cause the machine to shut down immediately. Or within a few seconds, or within a minute. It varied. My assumption was that this was the battery on the machine. So I replaced the battery. That didn't help. I had other issues with that replacement battery, so I replaced the battery again. Still didn't help. I said, okay, this seems like it's a Windows problem. Nope. I ran Linux on it for a day, and sure enough, in the middle of everything, it just shut down without warning. So clearly there is some kind of a hardware issue or some kind of a system-related issue here where the machine, even with a perfectly good, fully charged battery, was not reliably running on battery. I had spent a lot of time trying to resolve this issue. My intent was at that point to say, you know what? It's time to cut our losses. It's time to move on. I'd invested enough time, I'd lost enough time and money with those replacement batteries to say, you know what? I really don't have a good sense for exactly what's wrong here. I'm positive that if I spend enough time and money on it, I can repair it. But is that really the best use of my time? Is that really the best use of my funds? So that machine still runs. And in fact, it is running as we speak. It's off in a different room and now has a different role. The role it has simply means that it has to be plugged in all the time. As long as it's plugged in, it's a fine machine. I needed a laptop that I could run on battery. So I replaced it. I got myself a brand new machine. That machine arrived about a week ago as I'm recording this, and I've been using this, the new machine, for a while. I'm pretty happy with it. I will probably do another video or something about that particular machine. But the point here is that I made the decision to cut my losses and actually replace what, for the most part, was a working machine. But it wasn't working enough. I couldn't get it to run on battery, and for what I need that laptop to do, I needed it to run on battery. So like I said, it now has a new role. A lot of times, the decision on whether to repair or replace a machine can be fairly complicated. There are a lot of things to consider, a lot of things that factor into the decision on exactly what it is that's appropriate for your situation. I hope I've given you some things to think about, and by sharing my example of what I had to go through, give you a sense of what process you might want to go through should you run into this same scenario. For the article on which this video was based, for updates, for comments, for related links, including the machines involved and more, visit askleo.com/138316. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.